All right, Confessions from the Heart, episode 7. It's no longer gray hair, don't care. I had a diet. Wife got on my ass. As you can see, I can go old, I can go young. Don't fucking matter. All right, this is a good story here. I've told it before, but a lot of people have not heard it, which is why I want to give it again. This is my love for basketball getting my ass whooped. And school, when I made the transition from middle school to high school, my mom decided to send me to a school all the way up in the Northeast. So I lived in North Philadelphia. North Philadelphia is quote unquote the hood. The Northeast travel was probably like a 50 to 55 minute travel from where we live. So, you know, to leave out the house to get to school, we had to be to school by 8. I had to leave out the house by like 7. You know, 7:650 maybe. But when I went to George Washington, the one thing that I wanted to do was play basketball. I was like, yo, man, I want a chance to play varsity fucking basketball. At the end of the day, I'm making it to the NBA. This was a dream. I'm going to the fucking league. All I need is an opportunity. Mom, when basketball trials come, you know, the kid got to do it. Well, honey, I want you to do what you want to do and do what you believe you can. Yeah, basketball. It's going to be it. All right. George Washington's basketball team wasn't shit. The football team was everything. So the basketball tryouts was at 6 a.m. 6 a.m., which means that in order for me to make it, I would have to leave my house at 4:45 a.m. I told my mom about the tryouts. This is me going into the 9th grade. My mom said, absolutely not. You are not catching public transportation at 4:45 in the morning. No, not my son. So you can get knocked in your damn head or snatched. No, Kevin, absolutely not. Mom, what are you talking about? This is my dream. Right now, you are prohibiting me from going to the NBA. You not allowing me to go to this basketball tryout is hindering my basketball career. Kevin, you're not doing it. I guess you're going to have to wait till next year when they have tryouts at a reasonable time. Type of school has tryouts at 6 a.m. Don't make any damn sense. They're not thinking about the parents or the students. Fuck that. I heard what my mom said, but there's no way that I'm going to not pursue my dream. I came up with a plan. I said, the only way for me to make it to these tryouts is to make my mom think that the time is something that it's not. So what I did was I took every clock and watch in the house and set it to the times that I needed my mom to believe. So, in other words, when it was really 4:45 in the morning, I made it look like it was 6:45 in the morning. Granted, that's the time I had to leave out for school. I would leave out 6:45 so I could be to school at 8. So when it was really 4:45 a.m., all the clocks in my house read 6:45. The VCRs, the kitchen clock, the my mom's watch. We had a clock that was on our living room wall. Set them all back. It's a genius plan. Boy, that time came. I woke up. All right, Mom, I'm going to school. My mom was tired as hell. School, what time is it? What do you mean, what time is it? Why are you so tired? It's time to get your day started, Mom. 6:45, I got to go. I'm going to be late. All right. I must have overslept. She was groggy. I go. I'm out. On public transportation, I get to the school. Basketball tryouts is happening. I'm one of the first ones there. I give one of the best tryouts ever. Was it the best? No, but it was good enough for me to make the team, okay? Basketball tryouts go. We're now in school. I'm in class. You know how the school doors got those skinny little windows like this? I was in my third period, and I'll never forget my mom's head popping in that fucking space. Whop! I saw her looking around. She comes in, asks the teacher to come in. Teacher goes out. Then after that, she goes, teacher comes back and it goes, Mr. Hart, your mother would like to talk to you in the hallway. I have never been more afraid to go into a hall in my life. I knew what the fuck it was. I got up real slow, walked out. As soon as I stepped foot in that hallway, bah! had me at work 2 hours early because your stupid ass wanted to set the clocks back. My mom whooped my ass in that hallway. Not only did she whoop my ass, she told the teacher I would not be coming back to class. She made me go home on public transportation, whoop my ass all the way home on public transportation, whoop my ass from the walk, from the bus to the train, from the train to the goddamn next bus, from the next bus to our little ass apartment that we stayed in. I got my ass whipped 30 times. Went to school the next day, very sore. Found out I made the team. Came home, told my mom I made the basketball team. She said, you didn't make a goddamn thing but a mistake. You ain't playing basketball. My efforts fell on deaf ears. It took the coach talking to my mom about my ambition. Shouts out to Coach Jones. Talked to my mom about my ambition and how my future looked bright at George Washington. Granted, it didn't, but my coaches did a phenomenal job of stepping up for me. Convinced my mom that I was a good kid and that I was doing the right thing and that he hopes that there's a way where I can be on the basketball team. My mom found it in her heart later on to let me go, not before giving me my last smack on my mouth. Moral to the story is, sometimes time is not on your side, but you can make time what you want it to be. Make time for the things that you value, even if it requires an ass whooping sometimes. That mistake was a bad one, but it worked out for me in the long run. So it was bad, but it was good. Confessions from the heart.